Have you ever failed in doing something you love? And you're giving everything, all that you can offer, but nothing good as expected is coming out? Well, I have. My name's Joan Rowling. I'm a writer. I write about stories that has meaning to me. I'm currently writing a book that relates to my life and to one of my favorite writers. You probably know her. Her name's J.K. Rowling. Yeah, I know. We almost have the same name.
Broken bottles in the hotel lobby. Seems to me
Joan Rowling, best known as J.K. Rowling, was born in July 31, 1965 in England. Basically, her life was full of ups and downs. She declares that her teenage life was unhappy, considering that her mom, whom she was inspired to write from, was terribly ill, and her father, well, they have a strained relationship. She was married in October 1992 and gave birth to Jessica, her daughter, in 1993. As soon as the marriage ended, she and Jessica returned to the UK to live in Edinburgh, where her first published book, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, was eventually completed. Some failures in life are inevitable. It's impossible to live without failing at something unless you live so cautiously that you might as well not have lived at all, in which case, you fail by default. And the idea of just wandering off to a cafe with a notebook and writing and seeing where that takes me for a while, it's just bliss.
My name is Henry Porter. I'm an average boy who always finds confidence in everything that I do.
And wait. College, man.
I love my mom so much. She's the only one I cared about since my father left us when I was still a baby.
Hey Henry, have you reviewed?
What?
Have you reviewed for the long test?
Yeah, I'm just reviewing, so don't disturb.
Unfortunately, my mom died and left me too. Right now, I'm a college student. I always study hard in order to reach my dream of becoming a successful publisher.
Sorry for being late, class, but we're going to have our second exam in 5 minutes. Please be ready.
And I believe my journey to success starts now, so let's do this.
Okay, class, please pass your papers.
Doctor, please have a seat.
So how do you find my book?
Miss Rowling, your story is good. I find it good, but it does not fit the cover. This is not what we're looking for. I'm very sorry.
Thank you. I understand.
Maybe you should try other markers to check your work.
Okay.
Sorry.
Thank you. I wonder what went wrong, but I know for sure that it's not the end of my dream. I may have failed at first, but that doesn't mean that I'm a failure just yet. I won't give up. I know I can do this. I believe in myself. I know I can do this.
Okay, so I have your papers back now. Mr. Anton...
Today we'll know the results of the exam. I hope I'll pass, because I studied hard for this. Every time a professor calls a name, my heart beats faster and faster. I'm proud of my friends because they passed, and can you believe that? Even the pizza boy who didn't review passed. I think I'll pass too.
Thank you, miss. Mr. Henry Porter. I know you could have done better, Mr. Porter.
But when I got my paper, I feel like crying. All the things I've worked hard for became useless now.
ganyan. Nag-aaral ko, tapos bagsak pa rin. Kahit yung kumain ng pizza, pasado pa rin siya eh. So, bagsak. Gagawin ko, nag-aaral nga ako 3 days straight, tapos bagsak pa rin.
After all my classmates left, I cried so hard. I was so disappointed.
I didn't notice that I slept. Maybe because I was so tired. I was almost late in my appointment. The second publisher I went to was Mrs. Lahan.
What do you think of my book?
Who would want to buy this book? If I were the buyer, I would never buy it. It's a waste of money.
Please reconsider. I've worked really hard on this book.
You should do that.
Okay. I understand. Thank you for your time.
Unfortunately, I was rejected again. I want to give up now. But no. I know God has plans for me, and I believe in myself. Maybe, just maybe, I should try again.
Failing the exam didn't stop me from trying again. Even I failed the exam, I still thought of joining the cheerleading tryouts since it is my passion. I believe that there are always second chances. My friends have also joined and they are all good that all of them passed the tryouts. Will I also pass? Okay, it is now my turn. I am going to give it my best shot. I failed again for the second time. Am I really that unlucky, or was I not good enough? I think of something that can remove this madness, and I have decided to invite my friends for a party at my house tonight.
Yo guys, are you guys free tonight? Party at my house.
Probably should have not pushed myself too hard. Is it bad if I just want to relieve my stressors by drinking and having fun with my friends? I know it is, but this is where I find my happiness. That night, I got drunk, and when I woke up, everything was a mess. A big mess.
Crazy party last night. Shh, time is it?
Oh, fuck. I'm late. What's the point? I'm gonna be a failure anyway. I study hard yet I'm a failure pa rin. Maybe I just give up. Na naman kwenta ako eh. Saan ang wallet ko? Kwento naman yun. Uy!
So, how do you find what's this piece of garbage you sent me? It's Henry Porter, a boy who fails, and every time he does, he never gives up.
Wait! So, you're telling me I don't read this? You know what? I wasted 5 minutes of my precious time for this.
I worked really hard on that book. Please reconsider.
Wait. Unlike Henry Porter, you should give up on being an author.
Please, please, please. Please.
No. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Security.
I don't get it. I worked really hard on that book, and every time I publish it, I get rejected. I can't do this anymore. I can't.
Dear Joan, do you remember this picture? It is when we went on a date. A mother and daughter date. It may be our last date, because we don't know when God will take us back or when He'll get us. But before that happens, I want to tell you something. I am proud that you are my daughter, and I'm lucky to have you. Whenever you have problems, just be strong. Don't forget to pray to God. Thank Him for all the blessings that you have. Let your circumstances or obstacles become your inspiration. Stay humble, but do not let anyone step on you or affect you. Always remember that I am always here for you. And I love you so much. Love, Mom.
Mom's right. Henry Porter saw light after he read his mother's letter. He was inspired once again in reaching for his dreams.
Henry Porter?
Yes.
Congratulations.
He studied very well and focused. As a result, he passed all of his exams and got on the dean's list.
Yes.
He graduated college and got a degree. And now, he is a successful man working at a famous publishing company.
Please come in.
My book.
Your book has potential, I can tell you. And it'd be an honor for me to publish your book as soon as possible.
Really? You serious?
I'm serious. I believe everyone should deserve to see the life of Henry Porter. Because it applies to everyone. So as soon as possible by next week we'll have it published. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
5 years have passed, and that's how life is. The continuity of time will not stop and will never be stopped nor controlled. It is beyond anyone's control. Same goes with the struggles of life. Obstacles, failures, harsh words. Yes, I had the thought of giving up. I mean, who wouldn't? I was rejected multiple times by multiple publishers. Their vindictive criticizing words and rejection towards my writing have definitely struck me. But really, those words, their rejections, are just my motivations. Why do I talk about the benefit of failure? Simply because failure meant a stripping away of the essential. I stopped pretending to myself that I was anything other than what I was, and began to direct all my energy into finishing the only work that mattered to me. It's as easy and as fast as it sounds. But in reality, let's just say, she didn't get in her first try, nor her second, nor her third try. She was a successful failure.
Hold me close, we're losing time. Hold me close, we're falling to the ground. Taxi driver, sun is rising, down the sirens, keep on driving, flashing light. Oh, what a night, I miss your bed, I lost my head.